Yeah, hey, Mountain Church, Pastor Jim here, just thinking of you guys this morning, out feeding my flock and making sure they got water and making sure everybody's virus-free. And earlier this morning, I was reading out of Psalm 37, and David, this man after God's heart, just really, he just got it, you know? I mean, he made a lot of mistakes on his journey, and he failed a lot. And he was a sinner saved by grace. And he brought a lot of destruction into his own life because of his own decisions. But nevertheless, he was a man after God's heart. And he writes in Psalm 37 to trust in the Lord. And he links that together with and do good. Trust in the Lord and do good. And as a staff, we were keeping our social distancing yesterday at our staff meeting, and we were just gathered, and we were talking about this psalm, and just sharing from one another, just you know how we're learning to trust God in the midst of all of this. But we came back to it's part of trusting God is doing something about it, you know, and not just sitting on our hands. And not just, you know, going into full-blown quarantine and, you know, hoarding our stuff, but reacting like the church has always reacted in crisis and pandemics throughout history. There's a time to flee immediate danger, but there's a time always to love our neighbor. And that's what the church has always done. And you look all through church history, and the church has been one that has really been about the business of building the kingdom of God and the purpose of worshiping him and recognizing that one day we're going to die, all of us, and our chief goal in life is not to prevent our own death. The chief purpose of our life is not to live the most comfortable life possible and to die with the most toys. That is a very humanistic philosophy of life. That's not a Jesus philosophy. Our philosophy is, how do we love in the midst of all of this? And how do we love not just one another, but how do we love our neighbor? How do we do good while we're trusting God? Because I know we're trusting him. I know we know the Lord's going to carry us through this crisis, and he's going to carry us through this pandemic that's across the world right now that seems to be ramping up. I mean, it's serious. It's a real deal, you know. And nevertheless, we know as believers, the Lord's going to carry us through this. Of that, there is no question. And every man's got a number. Every day of man is numbered. God knows when we're going to be in his presence. And so if this is our time, if this is my time, I'm going to do everything I can to prevent it. I'm not going to pass it on to others. I'm going to protect and love my community. But if it's our time, it's our time. So I'm going to trust God in that. And in the meantime, I'm going to do good, and so are you. We're going to do what David learned and David wrote by the inspiration of the Spirit of God, is trust God, but be in the business of doing good, you know? I love what some of the warrior guys are doing. They're getting together and having Zoom prayer meetings. They're just inviting each other, saying, hey, let's get together and pray. I love what the staff is doing as they pray for you by name, as we're going through database names and just saying, we're going to pray for everybody that we know, and we're going to love everybody that we know, and we're going to be available to everybody we know. And the staff, they're warriors, by the way. The Mountain Church staff, they're warriors. And they've been just working day and night, just loving people and serving and making sure we're communicating well to the church, to the community, our community. And encouraging, you know. I love what Ryan shared with us last night via Facebook and all of our platforms about taking courage, you know. And how Jesus and Paul the Apostle were all about the business of encouraging us to be encouraged, you know. And Joshua was told the same thing by Yahweh, to be courageous, you know, in this time. And how we respond in this moment is really kind of a revelation of who I am, who we are. How I respond reveals kind of where I'm really at, you know. So I just want to encourage you guys, you know, keep trusting. The Lord's going to carry us to the other side of this, but in the meantime, do good. Do good. Man, memorize some scripture. Call a friend. Organize a Zoom meeting to pray with a few folks, or get online and get in the Word with some folks, or whatever you do, you know, make sure that your neighbors are taken care of, and you know, of course, keeping our social distancing, but making sure they have groceries and medications and whatever they need, and let's be the hands and feet of Jesus in this time. It's probably unprecedented, the opportunity that we have to do good in our community. So look forward to seeing you guys again on Sunday morning at 10 o'clock. Be sure and check in a little bit before that, like 10 till 10. You can get online, and we'll be starting our live service at that point. And man, just respond, you know, write in. Respond to the videos. We love to hear from you. We love to communicate with you guys. So looking forward to seeing you Sunday morning, and